Good afternoon, committee, Chair Councilman Reed Harimoto and Vice Chair Councilman Joey Manahan and council members. Thank you for this opportunity to speak to you this day. I really appreciate it. My name is Lori Nakamura Higa. I am a primary caregiver and a mother to my one and only child. And it is from this perspective that I am supporting the inclusion of CD1, the mandatory labeling of genetically modified organisms, to Resolution 12-13-19. Because of the precarious and controversial nature of GMOs that we are currently contending with, the message that this is sending to our children and everyone else. I know you have my written testimony. To save time, I'm going to skip certain parts, and you may look at them at your leisure. These GMO creators pride themselves on wanting to be the world supplier of food, and they've gone so far as to patent their foods. If they are so proud of their intentions and their products, then why don't they just label it? Cross-contamination has become a problem because of GMOs, and the GMO creators and non-GMO farmers both agree that they don't want cross-contamination. Litigating and suing, and litigating and settling against hundreds of farmers and taking their money is not the answer. The GMO creators should take responsibility and be held accountable for what they put out there, spend some of their billions of dollars and cover their farms with greenhouses. Okay, I'm going to skip over to this other section. These GMO creators are also the same creators of DDT, PCB, and Agent Orange. They also assured us that these products were safe, and we're all hauntingly aware of the reckless collateral damage done after the fact to the ecosystem, wildlife, and human life. Even now, they are reassuring us that GMOs are safe when there are no long-term human studies done. We are the scientific long-term human studies. While GMOs are secretly hidden in the foods that we eat, and the GMOs knows no discretion. We take these creators at their reassuring words and their studies that these GMOs are safe. Without labeling, we all, including you and your loved ones, are unknowing volunteers forced into the same long-term GMO study camp. Not any one of us holds exclusive rights. Recently, we memorialized our Veterans Day, and we all sit in hypocrisy while it's being kept a secret that our Vietnam vets are in fact eating GMO foods that come from the same pesticide creators of Agent Orange that injured, maimed, and killed them. How does one fathom the humiliating dishonor, degrading disrespect that our Vietnam veterans and their loved ones are subjected to? Where's the pride and integrity in that? Haven't our Vietnam veterans suffered enough? Jewish people, Buddhist vegetarians, Seventh-day Adventists, Muslims are all entitled to the right to choose what foods they wish to eat based on their beliefs and their religions. But others like me are not afforded that right, that same right to choose. Fostering the religious belief that was instilled in me as a youngster by my late grandmother is something I pay forward to my own child. We always believe that God created the heavens and the earth and everything in it. With GMOs, the creator is not God, but is a man-created, radically altered food that God did not intend. When our families sit down at a meal and I pray, I am repulsed and I feel so violated over thanking my God and asking him to bless these foods that he had not intended. To me, this is an abomination and desecration against my God and my beliefs. Prayer has become a sacrilegious offering of thanks, and again, ill-gotten profits are part of my daily contributions, sending a message that I condone to this bashing of my God. This makes me a hypocrite twice over, with Vietnam vets knowing what we know and what I'm doing to you in my own home. It has and is affecting my quality of life and that of my own family, especially with having to set aside time to not having to enjoy my child and to be a mother that I should be to her, because I have spent countless hours calling manufacturers and asking whether or not their products have GMO, and I am not anywhere near the exhausting my pantry, my refrigerator, my medicine cabinets. And now they are radically altering salmon with eel. If God had intended this to occur, then let God be the deciding one, not man. We've witnessed the GMO creators bring it on themselves time and time again. How untrustworthy, reckless, shameful, immoral, unethical, irresponsible, unaccountable they have been with their handling of their poisons, with our environment, our farmers, our Vietnam veterans, and ourselves. It's been dictated to us. Well, it's too bad. You're going to have to eat it, and we're going to have to profit from you, whether you like it or not. And if we choose to continue to degrade the dignity of Vietnam veterans and their families, too bad. They don't have a say in it either. And who cares about God and your religious beliefs? What we think and how much money we can get from you is what is most important here. If we have to force feed our pesticide, bacteria, virus-induced foods down your throat. And we're going to make sure that nobody is getting out of this. Not one person, not their loved ones. We hear them loud and clear. For this is the message that I have been forced to convey to my child. Committee members, chair councilmen, it is on your watch that this decision rests. As a mother, I respectfully ask that you support the inclusion of CD1, the mandatory labeling of GMOs, to resolution 12319. Thank you for your time.
I want to clarify for my colleagues here that it's not sunshine down, it's not in our packets. The conference committee draft that I have offered, I believe you said you support a CD1.
Okay, I'm sorry.
No. Well, the CD1 that I'm offering is to put back GMO labeling that the other three counties had asked for and to put back the repeal or dissolvement of the Public Land Development Corporation. So in your testimony today, are you in support of that committee draft?
I'm in support of labeling GMOs. If that's included in that, then that's correct.
It is, and that's why I want everybody here, my colleagues, is that when you hear folks testify, I support the CD1 to Resolution 12-319, the CD1 exists, I've written it, and you can deliberate later, but I think every testifier that comes forward, members, that says, I support a CD1, it's because that would be the reinstatement of GMOs and to dissolve the PLDC. Thank you.
I'm still learning.
We all are.